Good evening, everyone. I cannot say it's a pleasure to be here. None of us really have pleasure in debt. But I might tell you a little secret for those who know the Lord. In Psalm 116, verse 16, it says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the debt of his saint. God enjoys debt. Oh, don't tell us that. Yeah. But those who are called his saints. So don't get too scared. Okay. We shall begin. Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Would you please stand with me?
Most loving God, in a precious time like this, when we are lonely, when we are saddened, when we are broken, we look to you for comfort, because you are the comforter. You are the one that sees all things and know all things. And even those that are mourning at this moment, Lord, they can look to you because you are the comforter today. We bless you, God, for who you are, and thank you for your grace and your mercies thus far. And Lord, as we are here to pay our last respect to our mother, our sister, our aunt, a friend, Lord, we put everything in your hands, in your care, that you will take us through this moment. And Lord, at the end of it, it can bring us closer to you, that you, O God, will watch us, and you can say to us, well done. We ask, O God, that you will take absolute control and in charge of everything that will be said and done here this evening, in Jesus' name, amen. Mm-hmm. You can have your seat at this time. It is great pleasure. I welcome you to the Gore of Berean Bible Church. As the pastor and members, we also say a heartfelt condolences to you, the family, who are grieving at this time. We now have a hymn that says, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. If you have one of these here, it is right at the front, so you can sing with me. We have no music, we have a keyboard, but we don't have no musicians, so we can use our voice and sing, yes? So together we all will sing and make a joyful noise unto the Lord, right? Amen? Yes. All right, so we will sing together. We'll blend our voices together and we'll sing and we'll make a joyful noise unto the Lord this hour. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. If you have it, let us sing together at the count of three. One, two, and three. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior. My Savior, submission, visions of rapture now burst on my sight, angels descending bring from above echoes of mercies, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all that day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all that day long. A perfect submission, all is at rest. Eyeing my Savior, I'm happy, I'm blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in His love. This is my story, oh, this is my song, praising my Savior all that day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all that day long. The chorus again. This is my story, oh, this is my song, praising my Savior all that day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all that day long. Amen. This is my story, my song, praising my Savior all the day long, all the day long. Now we'll have the first scripture reading. So the person for the first scripture reading.
Good afternoon. The scripture reading is taken from John 14, 1 to 12. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. If ye had known me, ye should have known my Father also. And from henceforth ye know him and have seen him. Philip said unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and it sufficeth us. Jesus said unto him, Have I been so long time with you, and yet has not known me, Philip? He that hath seen me hath seen the Father. And how sayest thou then, show us the Father? Believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the work. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very work's sake. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. And that is the reading of the word of God. We now have another hymn that says, what a friend we have in Jesus. Is Jesus your friend? Do you want to make him your friend? Now is the time. Now is the place. Now is the hour. Make Jesus your friend. He's calling. What a friend we have in Jesus. The last page of you. Again, we'll sing together the count of three. 1, 2, and 3. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pains we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptation? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden? Come back with a load of care. Precious Savior, steal our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friend despise, forsake thee. Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his hands he'll take and shield thee. Thou will find a solace there. The last stanza again. Are we weak and heavy laden? Come but with a load of care. Precious Savior, steal our refuge. Take it through the Lord in prayer. Do thy friend despise, forsake. Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou will find a solace there. Yes, thou will find a solace there. Take it to to the Lord in prayer. There is nothing that God does not hear from us. Take it to the Lord in prayer. We'll now have the second scripture reading by Miss Augustine.
Second scripture reading is taken from 1 Corinthians 15, verse 45 to 48, and it reads, "And so it is written, the first man, Adam, was made a living soul. The last Adam was made a quickening spirit. However, that was not first, which is spiritual, but that which is natural, and after that, which is spiritual. The first man is of the earth, earthy. The second man is the Lord from heaven. As is the earthy, such are they also that are earthy. And as is the heavenly, such are they also that are heavenly." Amen.
Amen. Thank you for the reading of the Word of God. All right, now we'll have a special.
Good afternoon, everybody. There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. All is peace forevermore. And that happy golden show, what a day, glorious day that would be. What a day that will be, when my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. There'll be no sorrow there, no more burdens to bear, no more sickness, no more pain, no more parting over there. And forever I will be with the one who died for me. What a day, glorious day that will be. What a day that will be, when my Jesus I shall see, when I looked upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day that will be, when my Jesus we shall see. When we looked upon his face, the one who saved us by his grace. Oh, when he takes us by the hand and leads us to that promised land. What a day, glorious day that would be. What a day, glorious day that will be.
Indeed, a glorious day that will be when my Jesus I shall see. Is he your Jesus today? Make him your Jesus, that you can have that glorious day. Because the Bible tells us that the trump shall sound in it, and the dead in Christ shall rise, and those that are alive will be caught up to meet him in the air. So whether I'm dead and I rise to meet him in the air, whether I'm alive, I'm going to meet him. I'm going to meet Jesus someday. What a glorious day that will be. Amazing grace. How sweet the sound. We'll sing that hymn, and then we will have some tributes that will follow. Right, again, at the Congo of Tree, we'll sing together, 2, 3. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. It was grace that taught my heart to grieve. That grace appeared, the heart I first believed, through many danger, toil and snare, I've always saved us far, and grace will lead me home. The Lord has promised good to me. His words, my hope, secure. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. Amazing grace, the amazing grace of God, the unmerited favor that God has able to give unto us, that we shall have eternal life if we trust Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Tributes by Philip Benjamin.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Irma Dikoto. This is my sister. 46 years ago, I came to this church and stood here and buried my mother. 46 years after, I'm here with my sister, my only sister. She was a complex person, but she was my sister. I loved her. I will always love her. Unfortunately, she has one son. He couldn't be here today. And I'm going to say on his behalf, he loved his mother. There were trying times between them, but he loved her, and I know she loved him very much. Thank you very much.
So while we're on tributes, we're asking anybody that want to share anything. At this time, you can do so. The mic is open to anybody that want to share. Anybody wish to say anything? Anybody?
I'm her cousin, one of very many. As children, we grew up together. They in our house, and we visiting theirs, until we grew up and everybody grew apart. And I must say that I'm so proud to be a part of my family. According to me, there's no family like that on both sides. Life is difficult, and we all deal with it in different ways. And the last I saw of Merlin was, I saw her 2 weeks ago, two months ago, on the bus coming up. And I was sitting on the bus on one side, just about managed to squeeze in the last person. And when I looked across, I saw she was at the other end. And I bend over and I sort of stretched my hand, and she stretched her hand in front of those people. And we touched hands and we nodded, "You're all right." But when I got to go off, I forgot everything in my hurry to jump off the bus. And I forgot she was there, and I never did get to speak to her. I was thinking to speak to her, but I never did get to speak to her. Twice, when her brother died a long time ago in New York, I went over. I went over twice, and she was always there for me. She took me in and gave me everything she had, even things to take away, and treated me so well. And, you know, over the years, like I say, we have our challenges in life, and we lost touch. So on behalf of the Mola family, I just want to say, you know, we are sorry. One is gone. We only know that she's gone, but we are behind. So I just want to say, whoever she was, for whatever she was, every one of us have our own ways. And when we stand before God, he sees us for who we are, not judged by one of us, but judged by him who knows her heart only. And I hope and pray, I don't know what was in her heart before she died, but I always hope that Jesus is the last hope that people have, and she would have called on his name. And that's all I need to know. Just like the thief on the cross, who lived a life of sin, but on the last moment of his life, he was able to say in his heart, "Lord, I know you don't deserve that, but I deserve it." And you could see the sorrow in his heart. Nobody could see that in us. But Jesus could see it in us. And I hope and pray that it was like that for her.
Pleasant good afternoon, saints of God. I hail from the parish of Mardi Gras St. George's. Meeting Mullin for 40 odd years, she was like a mother to me especially. And then Junior come, and Junior is like a son to me also too. We never lost touch with no one, no matter what. Mullin might have her ups and downs, but yet still, she was a loving, caring and kind-hearted person. May her soul rest in peace. Mullin, thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Patricia Fullerton from Guelph. Mullin and I grew up like children together. We were schoolmates. My mother, her mother, both of them was working in the pool, and through that we became friends. When Mullin left and she went away, she told me she was going, everything. Well, it's Mullin and I. So I knew everything. But Mullin, we used to sing Sunday school songs together every morning. She said, Pato, sing that one. I said, Molo, sing that one. If I give a little encouragement in the morning, Mullin go give a little encouragement. We have in service, two of us over the phone. We have in service. And Mullin was very good to me, very, very good to me. And all about Mullin reality, Mullin talk about Junior. Oh God, where Junior? Oh God, where is Junior? I don't know Junior, man. I'm telling you, every day is a Junior and a Junior. I say, Mullin, take it right. She tell me Junior in the hospital and this kind of thing. I say, Mullin, take it right. But the thing that hurt me, although we doesn't know what God has in his mind, but I spoke to Mullin. We always speaking three and four times a day. Pato, what you eat? I eat so and so, and I hope you eat already, you know, because I know you like to walk. So I hope you eat already. I say, yes, Mullin. So I get up the morning, and I had a dream, and I found it so funny. I said, I got up. The bed I'm sleeping on. The foot of the bed turned into a road. And that road was made out of mud. I got up and I said to my children, I said, look, I don't have a nice dream at all. One said to me, Mommy, that must be sickness. I said, that's not sickness, that's death. She said, how you know that? I said, I'm an old man enough to know things and over. So when I call Mullin, no answer. I call again, no answer. Then Mr. Mark, I don't know if he's around, Mr. Mark tell me, Mullin dead. I said, what you saying there, boy? Mullin dead. He said, you calling Mullin, Mullin dead. I said, how Mullin could dead? Because I find it strange. How Mullin could dead? I said, so what you do when you see Mullin? He said, man, I get stupid, I turn dotish. I go and get neighbors and whatnot and whatnot. But in that hour, I could not go down to St. George's. So I told him, okay, the day of the funeral, I'm going to see him. I don't even know him, eh? Because me and Mullin are waiting upstairs, Mr. Mark downstairs. So I don't know Mr. Mark. But the thing about it, Mullin sings songs. We sing Sunday school chorus. We sing all kinds of chorus. She said, Pato, when that girl starts to give you word, sing, get thee behind me, Satan. And so we used to go on. So I don't like to say, I will miss Mullin. I miss Mullin. Since Mullin, they are bawling for mother. Look, I don't know what's funeral going on. What year is, I don't even know. Because they crying for Mullin. And anyhow, God knows best. It's a thing we don't know, but God knows best. I hope she make it in with him, because I always talk to her about God. I say we could sing, We could all sing, but the best thing, if you make your heart right to God, sometimes you speak many bad words, but I don't accustom with that. But I say, make your heart right to God. So, God in the midst, okay, all right.
Amen. You know, sometimes when we meet each other on the street and we say, how are you doing? Sometimes we say, I'm good. And we know down in our heart we are not good. There's a song that says, it is well with my soul. But even if you are sick and you are not good, I hope you can say, it is well with my soul. So we'll turn to that song and we'll sing this one before we have the other thing on the program, theology. All right? It is well with my soul. Again, at the count of three, we'll sing together, blending our voice and making a joyful noise. Two, three.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my Lord thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul, it is well with my soul. If it's well, if it's well with my soul, though Satan should buffet, though trial should come, let this blessed assurance control, that Christ has regarded my helpless estate and had shed his own blood for my soul. It is well with my soul. If it's well, it is well with my soul. My sin, oh, the bliss of his glorious thought. My sin, nothing but bath the whole, is nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, oh my soul, it is well with my soul. If it's well, if it's well with my soul, and Lord hears it when the faith shall be sight, my sin as a scroll, the trump shall resound, and the Lord
Everybody say, it is well with my soul. If it's well, if it's well with my soul. Amen. Hallelujah. It is well with my soul. At this time, we'll have the theology. That will be done by.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is listed on the program that the eulogy will be done by Omadi Koto. That's the person that was standing here before. That's her sister, but I will be doing it on her behalf. Okay? It started. What can we say about my sister? I can use one word to describe her, and that is complex. Merlin, Jane, Hosten, Spencer, Wellington was born on November 23rd, 1949 in Moran, St. John's to Iris Thomas and Bertie Hosten. She attended the St. John's Anglican School. She was employed at the Marketing and National Importing Board and then later, Her Majesty's Prison for a period of time. Merlin married and moved to Madigrat, St. George's, with her then-husband, Anthony Spencer. She lived a good life with him, but that life was soon cut short with him passing away at a young age. Merlin later migrated to the U.S., where she spent some time, then moved to London. It was there she met her childhood friend, Everall Wellington, and they began a beautiful relationship. They both returned to Grenada, where they got married and then returned to London. Unfortunately, their marriage did not survive the test of time, and Merlin returned to Grenada and settled in La Mode, St. George, where she lived up until the time of her passing. Merlin is survived by her son, Philip, and his wife, Merlin, two grandchildren, Juliana and Jeremiah, sisters, Irma, Joan, Shirley-Ann, and Margaret, brothers, Showin, Cecil, and Bernard, and sister-in-law, Louise Thomas, many nieces and nephews, neighbors and friends, including Valerie, Humlin, Zillette, Patricia Belgrave, Jude, and Diana, the Hostins, Gunpot, Thomas, Benjamin, and the Muller family. My dear sister, speaking in Irma's voice, Merlin, you lived a good life. May you rest in perfect peace.
Very short and very nice. Very short and very nice. You know, in life, we always have a message, and every one of us have a message. Every one of us have a message to carry. A message because, you know, the Lord will ask us, because he wants to know what is your message. Saying all this to say to you that we will now have the message. And that will be done by no other person than Pastor John St. Bernard, who has filled this pulpit for many years in his life. Now enjoying his retirement, I should say, as he's here with us today to give the sermon, as I said, I call it the message. And it is for us. It is not for the dead. But it's for us to grasp the message. The message. So I hope that when we leave here, that the message will go with us. The message will go with us. And it will stand the test of times in our life. So at this time, without further ado, I'll now call Pastor John St. Bernard, who will deliver the message. Amen.
Thank you very much, Brother Showing. It's good to stand up and watch that. Here's a younger one that could give the ultimate shoulder. He has taken over from John St. Bernard. Not from me, right? I notice we have a few visitors. Yeah, a lot. You all are visitors. So I want to say welcome. Thanks for being here. What do I know about Molly? Nothing. Except I may have remembered her in camp. You remember that? I would have remembered her in camp, but it's a long time ago. Something that I was kind of taken aback with is her birth, her date, and her year. Guess what? I was just a few days before her. Days, eh? Not years. So it's good that she lived a good life. When I say that, God give us 70 and 10, and once we get that, we should be praising God for the rest. Just keep praising God. Every extra day I have, I said, thank you, Lord, and I'll give you a joke about me. I listen to that announcement. And when I'm listening to that announcement, 46, I beat that. 50, I beat that. I beat a lot because I passed that. Amen. And I'm glad that God gave me the life and the strength to live on. I'm going to share a thought with you. It could be troubling. Okay? One of the things I've been thinking about for a couple of years now is this. People are afraid to die. And I asked myself the question, why? So I put it in a little thing like that and I said, why are we afraid to go home? I know I'm troubling people right now. Don't you notice that? We are afraid to go where? To go home. When somebody dies, we say, oh, they're in paradise and they're in heaven and they're in a better place, but we are still afraid. Isn't that true? The question I'm asking is, why are we afraid? So I look around me in my society, in society, and you look at people and you pay attention to things that happen. You will notice that men sometimes are afraid to go home. Men say amen, please. That's not true. Some men are afraid to go home. I'll tell you why they're afraid to go home. From the time they reach on this step, will you come out? What you do down the road? And then you sit down and then you hear wap, 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 wap. So that makes you afraid to go home. Isn't that true? Men, you're afraid to go beach you tonight again? But that doesn't only go for the men. Some women are afraid to go home. Isn't that true? See, they're keeping quiet, right? Too quiet for my own good. Some women are afraid to go home. Some men are afraid to go home. Then it tells you that something is wrong with that home. If the wife is afraid to go home, something is wrong. If the husband is afraid to go home, something is wrong. This little example is to teach you something that we should know and maybe give it a serious thought. Jesus said something like this in John chapter 14, from verse 1 to 4. You're going to listen to it, and we're going to talk about it, right? He said this. We're going to start. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, ye believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. But I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, ye know, and the way, you know. This passage that Jesus gave us was to give us a high level of assurance. Okay? He wants to give us, or he gives us assurance. Assurance that while you are living on earth, I am making preparation for you when you come after. Okay? He was saying, like the husband, he goes to the United States or Canada to work and to make preparation that when he comes home, he can build a nice house for his family. Isn't that true, fellas? And Jesus is saying to you, look, I am telling you something that I want you to believe. And I'm going to tell you this. One, the first assurance is that, let not your heart be. We are living in fear, and this is troubling our heart. A lot of us will die of heart attack. We will be in places where we crumble and fall because of fear. And Jesus said, don't allow your heart to worry. Or don't worry your heart, if you want to put it like that. And I'll tell you why. So if you are living in this world where everything seems to be falling apart, not seems to be, it is falling apart. It therefore means we need people with strong mind. And the mind has to have a lot of assurance. We sing the song, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. So, mind must be full with assurance. Assurance that when I die, I will continue to live with Jesus Christ. So please, that's Jesus pleading with you. Do not worry. Do not worry about death. Why? I'm jumping ahead of myself. Because Jesus conquered death. When he was crucified, you remember they buried him? And he rose again from the dead? That was victory over death. And if death is the thing that keeps you frightened or afraid, Jesus saying, hey, I have beaten this one. So don't let it hold you down. Let not your heart be troubled. And we need that level of assurance. You know, a lot of people give us assurances. But you know what happened to them? I am assuring you that this will not happen. And we'll do this. And then when you depend on it, all fall apart. I want to tell you this. Jesus never failed. He never breaks his promise. Like he said, and lo, I am with you always. And I'll assure you that he is. The psalmist had this to say, yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Guess what? Why? That's assurance, isn't it? Real assurance. So once you have this assurance, why are you afraid to go home? He gives us the assurance. Let us move on. Because I promised not to keep people in church too long. Brother Joseph? Right. Right, he said this in my father's... No. Let not your heart be troubled. One. If you believe in God, believe also in me. You know your belief has a lot to do with your mind. What you believe shapes how you go along in life. Your belief system is very important. some people may call it, your philosophy in life guides you. If you have none, then you live carelessly. You don't have one. If you have one, you live with purpose. And as you live with purpose, you will die with a purpose. Isn't that true? When you die with a purpose, you will see death coming and say, oh, death, where is thy victory? Oh, grave, where is thy sting? Because that life is full of purpose. Why? You believe in Christ Jesus. Isn't that what Jesus said? Let not your heart be troubled. Don't let it happen. Please don't let it happen, because you know you won't get hurt in the process. You believe in God, you also believe in me. What Jesus was claiming, equality with the Father. If you believe in God, you also believe in me. If you believe in me, you also believe in God. You don't separate them. Right? So he said, just put that confidence in me, and then your heart wouldn't be troubled. No, I am not going to tell you in this life that you'll have perfect peace. That's not true. But you will have peace in Christ. Peace that passeth all understanding, that Christ give to you. And that he give to all of us who trust him. So we need that assurance. We need that guarantee. Now we're going home. You ready for us to go home? That's what them fellas say when they go to that party, right? I ain't going to ask you that. Because I wouldn't let you go home. Right. So we're going home. In my Father's house. Isn't that what he says there? In my Father's house. No, no, it's time to go home. I was told a long time ago, a house may not necessarily mean it's a home. And I think I understand that. When I tell you I understand it, I understand it. A house does not necessarily mean that is a home. It could be a house with people, but you're not going on in that house. Right? So it does not. But Jesus is talking about a house that will and is a home. In a home, there will be misunderstanding. Isn't that true? In a home, there will be conflict. But guess what? In a home, the family will be able to resolve those conflicts and problems. That's what it is. So you might be afraid to go home because of the conflict. You might be afraid to go home because you think something is wrong. I'm telling you, with God, going home, you should be joyful when you're going home. It's not a time to mourn. I had to speak to some close relatives of mine because I was diagnosed with something. And I said, what? I said, stop. I just said, no, stop. So let's talk something positive now. Let's go. Right? Fear. Let me tell you something. I know God. I ain't talking about I believe God. I know God. And God speaks to me. That is why I'm not afraid of what will happen tomorrow. As a matter of fact, that's none of my business. Years ago, I used to make joke about death, life and death. The young pastor, they say, you taking this thing like a joke? It was a joke to me. Because I know what it is. I'll tell you that death has a sting. You don't believe that, no? It hurts and it burns. Here, the Apostle Paul, as he writes to the Corinthian believer, chapter 15, 1 Corinthians 15, he said, oh, death. What is it again? I can't remember. Where is thy sting? Oh, grave. And then he said, thank be to God who had given us the victory. Yes, he acknowledged death has a sting, but grave does not have that victory. The grave does not have that victory over us. Some of us may be here when Christ comes to take his saints. Praise God for that. And some of us will go before he comes. But don't be afraid to go home. I don't want you to be afraid to go home. I think it's time for me to cut this. But here, the only how you will not be afraid is if you trust in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. I'm not inviting you to this church. I'm inviting you to Jesus Christ. As a matter of fact, I don't have time for that anymore. Maybe I get old. It's time for us to point people to Jesus Christ. And tell you what he says and what he has in store for you. In my Father's house are many mansions. And if it was not true, I would have told you. In other words, he said, I'm Mama Guy in you. Forget that. I will never tell you any untruth. What I'm telling you is what I know is true. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it was not so, I would tell you. In other words, I would tell you the truth. You know one thing I learned about truth? Truth does create a lot of confusion. If you want to have enemies, speak the truth. I hear somebody bawling. You didn't believe that? When I was young, I used to tell people, anytime I don't want people to believe me, I don't lie for them. I watch them straight in the eye and I tell them the truth. I hear what they tell me, I don't believe that. Great, and I go on. We have problems with truth, isn't that true? And we have real problems. Jesus said, you shall know the truth. The truth shall set you free. So why do we have problems? Why are we having problems with truth? He said, if it was not so, I wouldn't tell you. Jesus was saying, I'm not going to lie for you. He just wants to tell the Pharisees, he said, what? I tell you the truth and you will not believe me. And when he told them the truth, they were prepared to kill him just for telling the truth. But for you who claim to be followers of Jesus Christ, this truth is to give you assurance and confidence that after you shall leave this place, you are going home. You can sing, going home, never more to Rome. I'm going home. I'm going to meet my Savior. I'm going to meet my Lord. I'm going to see him face to face. That is what I'm going to do. So I'm not afraid to go home. When I was 13 years old, I was in hospital. I had an accident. And I watched three persons die. As a 13-year-old, you know, you're fast, right? You want to see what's going on. The first one, he was at some to the back there, the distance from me. And this gentleman, he got up, he rolled, he put him back down. Next thing, he get up from the bed and he run. They eventually hold him, they brought him down and they tie him down on the bed. You know, he died there. He died being tied down. The next one, We were about same age, and I understood that he fell from a coconut tree, so that means he was disagreeable like me. And I always remember that Sunday evening, his parents brought food and coconut water for him. And as they brought it for him, he ate more than any time. So we were feeling good coming up. But all of a sudden, the nurses start running and they pulling the screen around him. And I heard him say something like this. Oh Lord, I'm coming home. And that did it. He died. And then there were one next very close to me. He said, put me sit down. And the up and down, up and down. Why are we afraid? Because we do not trust what is beyond. We have no confidence in that what is beyond there. We just call it the great beyond. We give it all kind of a name, but we don't trust it. So that is why we are afraid. Maybe tonight, at this evening, it's time for you to get rid of that fear. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love and power, and a what type of mind? A sound mind. You know, when you have a sound mind, you could relax. Right? So this is what he has given to us. Not fear. If you are afraid to death or to die, you better trust Jesus Christ today. If you are afraid that there is nothing, something for you to be afraid of beyond there, no. Let me tell you this. Jesus given us the assurance. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again to receive you unto myself. He's ready to receive you. But if you choose not to, you could be afraid. You see, we don't like to talk about hell. And let me tell you that and run. God never created hell for man. Hell was made for a particular group. Right? Satan and the bunch that went with him. Not for you. God is not willing that you should perish, but you should come to repentance. Let me say this. If you go there, it is not God's fault. It is your fault because you are rejecting what he has done for you. What will you do today? You either trust him or you live in fear. Stop living in fear. I don't want you to live in fear. I want you to have that blessed assurance where you relax and trust in the Lord, knowing that his hands will carry me through. You remember we said in Psalm 23? Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Guess what? I will, what the word is again? Fear no evil. Because you are with me. He is with you. He promised, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Not a fella telling a girl, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, and 6 months after they're gone. You know that? Yeah? I love you until I'm dead. I don't know if you mean mentally dead, but they're gone, right? And a lady tell you, oh, sweetheart, I love you. And then you know what happened? That's not how Jesus did it and how he's doing it. He loves you with an everlasting love. Will you trust him today? Don't worry about Molly. What are you worrying about? You will see something different. Right? Don't worry about her. So, bow your head with me, please.
The message. Sometimes we put an age to death. Back in the 80s and in the late 90s, when you hear somebody die, you're looking at the death news and you're looking at 60 upwards. But we are living in these days, and the reality is that death is no respecter of person. And we all have to be aware that it is coming. We cannot run from it. You will run, but you cannot hide. So I say this to say, would you trust Jesus today? Would you give him your life now? Would you surrender to him? Say, Lord, here am I, a sinner, want to be saved by grace. If you do so, if you think so, if you want to do that, come, come, come. Bow your heads with me. Dear God, we humble ourselves before you this hour. Again, God, with hearts that is filled with sorrow, some with joy, the Lord, knowing that you are the great comforter, we seek your face at this hour. And Lord, for those that wants to make a commitment to you today, Lord, as they speak to you from the heart, knowing that you know the thoughts of man afar off, hear the cry and attend unto the prayer. Thank you for your word and the encouragement that we have gotten from the message, O God, so that we can leave here knowing that there is hope. We can leave here knowing that there is life after death. We can leave here knowing that there is eternal life. Thank you again, O God, for the man that you have used to proclaim your word today. And we ask that you will bless our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. So before we sing the closing hymn, I will ask the immediate family to please come close. Family. So at this time, I say to you that it is a time to come close. It is a time to be together. And one thing that death has done, he has bring family close. And whatever the issue or whatever, if there is any, we need to trash it out and let God have his way. So I'll pray for you at this time. Dear God, we bring before you this family. Lord, I bring them before you that they will come together. When Christ stood up and prayed, he said that, Lord, let there be one as we are one. And I pray, God, for the oneness, the unity among them. And that in itself, oh God, would bring them closer to each other, that the sharing and the love and the togetherness will surround. God, I pray against the wiles of the enemy, the devil, O God, who is seeking to devour, to kill, to steal, that he will not steal away the joy or the happiness, O God, but he will stay afar off. God, take control of this family. Be in the means. Be in the way, in the decision making, O God, that whatever decision they make, it will be in you, God. And for your purpose and for your glory. In Christ Jesus. Amen. May God bless you. As we sing our closing hymn, when we all get to heaven, but before we sing, we have Miss Charles. Would you come, please?
Good afternoon again. On behalf of Merlin Jane, hosting Spencer Wellington, the family and her sisters and other relatives here, they want to express their heartfelt thanks for every one of you that chose to celebrate the life of Merlin here today. We want to extend a heartfelt thanks to Lockwood Brothers for their service and for, you know, taking care of Merlin, make sure that she's well presented and have a good send-off.
We want to thank Pastor Shawn Joseph and Pastor John St. Bernard for officiating and delivering the service, the word today. We also want to thank Mikey Live for bringing the service for her son and those in the diaspora that cannot be here today that are witnessing, and all the well-wishers, her special friends, neighbors who would have extended their condolences, those who would have come, said a good word, who would have prayed. Everything that what you have done was very much appreciated. And as we leave today, we just want to share the fact that we thank you for everything. And although this is a solemn moment, we want to make sure that to let everyone know that even in death, there are troubling times, and we should just take this moment to because all of us know that Merlin died sudden. So this particular death should tell us that, you know what, life is not ours. We can go anytime, any day. And the message was, make it right. Everybody echoed, make it right with your maker. Make it right with your neighbors. Make it right with your family. Because we don't know if we walk out this door today, if we be back here tomorrow. Life is not ours. So to the family, may God comfort you in this time of bereavement. And to the family and friends who are actually grieving at this point too, may God comfort us all. And thank you for your presence here today. Thank you.
Right, so before we have the closing of the casket, would you have the final viewing, and then we will sing the closing hymn, and then we will head to the cemetery. So we have the final viewing, family, at this time. All right, let us sing at this time, when we all get to heaven. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercies and his grace. In the mansion bright and blessed, he prepared for us a place. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout a victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, cloud will over the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sight. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout a victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will.
We...
when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be when we all see Jesus. We'll sing and shout a victory. Onwards to the prize before us, soon His beauty will behold. Soon the palace gate will open. We shall tread the streets of gold. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout a victory.
Amen. May God bless you as we take the body to the cemetery for the final farewell.
There is a living hope that Jesus Christ has resurrected from the dead. And for the family, listen, all should comfort you that there is resurrection after death. To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under the heavens, a time to burn, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to break down, a time to build up, a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to moan, a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, a time to refrain from embracing, a time to lose, a time to keep, a time to hold, and a time to tear, a time to swear, a time to keep silence, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace. We have gathered here to commit to rest the body of Merlin, our loved one, our friend. There is, from time, one memory we treasure. Some of us have shared, through the passing years, wonderful companionship with our loved ones. Let us cherish many moments, memories that come to us from time to time in each purpose. The Lord is the light of my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? All our sins and grief to bear, what a privilege to carry every. everything to God in prayer. Oh, at peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pains we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. No, not yet. Hold on. There's trouble anywhere. We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. So faithful, who will all our sorrow share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Weak and heavy laden, come but with a load of care. Precious Savior, still our refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Forsake thee, take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou will find a soulless there. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? Seek the Lord while you may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Shall not be the judge of all the earth in right. You could cover. Go ahead. Thanks. Father alone will know all about it. Father alone will understand why. Tear up my brother, live in the sunshine. He understands it all by and by. Understand why. Cheer up my brother, live in the sunshine. He understand it all by and by.
Father alone will understand why. Cheer up, my brother, live in the sunshine. We understand it all by and by. Coming in glory, when we come from Him,
I'm full image.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art.
And his grace in the mansion, bright and blessed, he prepared for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, cloud will overturn the sky. But when traveling days are over, to not a sight. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. True and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory, oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Onwards to the prize
before us, it will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Of the golden morning, that silver sun.
shall be no more. And the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the silver shall fall on the other shore.
And the roses call up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
On that bright and cloudless morning when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his
resurrection share.
When the chosen ones shall gather on the home beyond the sky.
And the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and the work on earth is done, and the road is all up yonder, I'll be there. When the road is all up yonder, when the road is all up yonder, when the road.
To behold him standing on the starry side, face to face in all his glory,
the most great.
I shall see him by and by. Only faintly now I see him, when the darkness veil me
faces and behold him far beyond the starry sky. Face to face in all his glory, I shall see him by and by.
Yeah.
Shall we pray? Father, we gathered in this solemn place to remember the life and mourn the death of our loved one. We ask that you will comfort each family member and friend. Be returned to your word for comfort, for encouragement, to happy memories and purpose for their hearts to seek you while you may be found. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you, and the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift you up, his countenance upon you, and give you peace. Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm.